I was actually so bad that if you wanted to know the strength of the class, like the total number of the students in my class, you could just look at my rank. So suppose there were like 50 students in the class, you take my rank, which was 48 or 49, just added a number in it, and you would get the total rank, right? The total number of the students in the class. So my parents would change a tutor after every few months because the tutor was not making any difference, right? So I was always getting marks like 2, 0, 4 out of 25, and my report card would be filled with red marking to show that I failed the subject, right? But thankfully it all changed when I got in fourth grade, right? Because I finally found this teacher. To give you one more example, when I was in the first semester of the fourth grade, I got out of 800 marks. I want you people to guess how many marks I got out of 800.
1,000.
Another guess.
50.
So I got 176 marks, which is around 20 push, right? So in the second semester, I was introduced to this teacher, and by the third semester, I worked very hard. I was going there for 5 hours, right? Like at 1 I would get off from the school, at 3 I would go to work, and then usually I would stay till 8, but sometimes I would stay till 10. And by the third semester, I got 626 marks, which is almost 78%. So if we rounded off to 80%, so it was like improvement from 20%. It was a huge improvement for me. And I finally realized that I could also get good marks. After that, I became an average student, but when in A levels and O levels, I performed well and got in top. So that's it. Now, why did I become a doctor? I always thought of becoming a lot of other things, a lot of other professions like banker, because my father was a banker. So since I idolized him, I thought I would become a banker. I thought of doing ACCA because my brother was doing ACCA. Then there was pilots because I thought pilots are cool. Then there was scientists because my teacher thought scientists were cool, thought they were cool. But then why did I choose medicine as a profession? So there are two reasons why I chose medicine. The first one is that my father told me to become a doctor. So when I was choosing a subject for O levels, my father told me you should become a doctor because the thing with doctors is that they can never go hungry because they are always so, but the profession has always a job place in market. Right? That was the number one reason, but when I was in A levels, I had this friend who introduced me to comic books. And to be more exact, it was Japanese comic books called manga. And while I was reading them, I came across this comic book called Team Medical Dragon, and which it was about a thoracic surgeon. And after reading it, I thought that, if doctors do that, then I want to be saving life like that. Right? So, that's why I became a doctor. Other than that, I love physics, so if I was not a doctor, I most probably have done a PhD in physics or something like that. Why am I here? So the short answer is that I'm very scared of public speaking. But the long answer is that I've always known that I'm scared of public speaking. But when I was in third year of my medical college, one time I was supposed to take the history of the patient, which is basically you ask the patient, why did you come to the hospital? And after taking a detailed history, I was supposed to present it in front of my one of the professors and my friends, right? But I was so scared that I literally started panicking, and I actually had a panic attack, and I could not speak, right? Like, I was feeling like I was suffocating, and I did not complete the history. So the professor took the history himself at the end, right? So that's what happened. So I started searching on the internet, what can I do to overcome this fear? And there I came across this guy whose name was Danny Laprop. And I thought he's some scam artist because he had this website that was not that well made. Right? I thought that he's some scam artist, and he was teaching how to become a good humor speaker, right? Humor speaker. And I thought, I've never heard about him, so he must be some scam artist. So I went to his YouTube channel, and there I came across this video where he was answering questions. And he answered one of the questions. Someone asked that, I am scared of public speaking, should I buy a degree? So he said that, look, what you have is fear of speaking, and the best way to overcome fear of speaking is to get on stage. So his motto is stage time, and then he introduced to in that video about Toastmaster. So So that's how I actually got to know about Toastmaster. So I started searching about it, and it turned out that the funny thing is that this guy is the 2001 world champion of the Toastmaster, right? So that's how I came to Toastmaster. Now I initially became a member in 2015, but I was not active. I only stayed a member for 2 years. So I found out that, and I've met TM Akhil, GT Akhil, and a lot of other people who became joined the Toastmaster after me and actually became DTL. So if I had worked hard that time, I could have also been a DTL. So I'm hoping that I'll also be active now and become a DTL. And